Hi folks, welcome back to the Asset Form channel and thanks for tuning in. In this particular video I will discuss what kind of objects are out there to see and image for the month of May in 2020. This is a new thing I'm trying out on my channel, so let me know if you like it. And I'm also looking for your participation. So without further ado, let's get into it. So obviously Comet Swan is the main attraction in the month of May 2020, but there are other beautiful objects to look out for during this month as well. So I will discuss the following things. So first of all, I will get into near-Earth objects, so comets and asteroids that are currently in our solar system. Secondly, I will talk about the positions of our planets and our moon. And thirdly, I want to discuss some nice deep sky objects you are able to image in the month of May when you have an equatorial mount and a telescope and a camera. And also I would like you to participate in these kind of videos by sharing your pictures with me if you like that using Instagram. So I will also explain how that works. So without further ado, let's get into the first topic of near-Earth objects. So the first thing to look out for in May is Comet Swan, because this is the comet of the moment. And currently it has an observed magnitude of 5.2 at the time of this video. And that makes it visible to the naked eye if you have access to darker skies. And more specifically, you can see it during the first and the second week of May from the southern hemisphere. And look towards the east, high up in the constellation Cetus, where this comet will steadily climb above the horizon and rise from 4 a.m. onwards until sunrise. As for the northern hemisphere, we have to be patient and pray that this comet will actually survive the solar winds for the coming 2 weeks. It will be visible in the final week of May. So just after sunset, Comet Swan will be visible to the northwestern evening sky in the northern hemisphere. So it will be in the constellation Perseus, where it will steadily decrease in altitude while moving towards the north and northeast during the night. And for more details on Comet Swan, you can check out my recent blog I wrote on my website. And it shows you the exact location of the comet in the night sky on different nights, as well as tips on how to photograph Comet Swan with a regular DSLR camera. So with all the attention on Comet Swan at the moment, we would almost forget that there are also two other comets out there in the northern hemisphere that have an observed magnitude lower than 9. Comet Atlas C2019Y1 is currently at its closest distance from Earth at 1.1 astronomical units. So that's about 165 million kilometers from Earth. And at the time of this video, the comet reports a magnitude of about 8.7. And it is located in the constellation Camelopardalis, and I hope I pronounce this correctly, in the northern hemisphere. This comet is circumpolar, and this actually means that it can be seen and captured after sunset during the whole night. Comet Pan-STARRS C2017T2 is currently at perihelion, that is the closest point from the sun, and at its closest distance from Earth at 1.7 astronomical units. So that's about 250 million kilometers from Earth. The observed magnitude is currently also 8.7. And that means that you can see this comet again with the help of a small telescope or some binoculars. So next, let's talk about some interesting positions of our planets and our moon in the month of May. I have to say that I will concentrate on the northern hemisphere as I am most familiar with my own hemisphere. When looking at the northern hemisphere, we can see that Venus will still be in the eastern sky just after sunset. And although Venus will be still very bright at a magnitude of -4, so it will be brighter than any other star that is in the night sky. It will also appear to be lower in the eastern sky with each passing day. And just before Venus says goodbye, and just before it will pass below the horizon, it has a very special treat for us. So please take this into account, write this down in your agenda, because on the 22nd and the 23rd of May, Mercury and Venus will have a conjunction. And the conjunction basically means that they will appear very close together in the night sky. And I did some calculations, and actually Venus and Mercury, they will fit in like a single shot with a regular DSLR camera with a regular like 80 millimeter lens. So that's very nice, I think. So the perfect opportunity to photograph the two planets together. And on the 24th of May, there will also be a crescent moon that is relatively close to Venus and Mercury as they are passing each other. And it's in the eastern sky just after sunset. Look out for that. Take your DSLR camera or maybe just your smartphone. You can spot them and make a very nice picture of these conjunctions. Jupiter and Saturn will rise in the southeastern sky and will be visible from about 3:30 a.m. onwards. They will move towards the south while also increasing in altitude until sunrise. Jupiter will be the brightest planet in the sky with a magnitude of about -2.5, whereas Saturn will have a magnitude of about 1.2. Mars will rise at about 4 a.m. in the east southeast and traveling towards the southeast and increasing in altitude until sunrise. The waning moon will be in close proximity to Jupiter and Saturn on May 12th and close to Mars on May 15th. Let's talk about some deep sky objects that are out there in the night sky in the month of May in the northern hemisphere. So very good news for people who are interested in white field nebula. Finally, after galaxy season, the Milky Way, or at least part of it, will be visible again from midnight until sunrise. And in particular, the constellation Cygnus will be very interesting. It will rise in the eastern sky just after midnight, and it will move towards the southeast while rising in the night sky. And this provides, of course, a great opportunity to image our beloved objects in Cygnus. So think about, for instance, close to the star Sodder, you will find the famous Crescent Nebula, or NGC 6888. Very nice to image. And also close to the NAB, you can start to capture the famous North America Nebula, the NGC 7000. And also the Pelican Nebula, just next to the North America Nebula, IC 5070. Although each of these objects will move higher up in the sky and more to the south in June and July, you might want to profit from the fact that the nights in May are just that little bit longer, which may allow you to get all of that narrowband data you want to get. And for those of you who have bigger scopes and are really into galaxy hunting, unfortunately the months March and April are gone, but still Ursa Major is very high in the night sky still. I think this is the final month you can still capture these famous galaxies, such as the Whirlpool Galaxy M51, the Pinwheel Galaxy M101, and you can still capture those in May as well. So one final thing, I'm really looking forward to making my channels more interactive, because this is social media, right? So I would really appreciate it if you would be willing to share some of the pictures you take in May from the objects that I have just mentioned with me. And you can do that on Instagram by just including my handle. So if you share a picture on Instagram, just include @astroforum and also use the hashtag NSASFO, so Night Sky Astro Forum. I will respond to those pictures you are making, and I will make a selection of those pictures and I will show them in my next monthly night sky update video in June. I don't want to make this into a competition. So if you're just starting out and you want to share your first astrophotography picture, or you're just making wild, beautiful wide field shots with your DSLR camera and you're willing to participate in this monthly update video, please share those pictures with me. And I will make a selection and I will show them in my next monthly night sky update video in June. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please consider subscribing to my channel. I saw that I'm close to 3,000 subscribers already, so thank you very much for doing for subscribing. I really appreciate that. And I hope, of course, to see you again in one of my other videos on my channel. And until then, I want to wish you clear skies.